James and I were talking with another associate, and the other associate kept saying, you know what, guys, I think I may be able to get for you and for your population a great improved access to Dexcom 6 CGM, continuous glucose monitoring. And I said, that's fantastic. I said, you know, by the way, we're currently doing that with Libre. And James and Yanni both said, yeah, I get it, I understand. And James and I went for about, how long was it, James, before you realized?
It was over a week. I'm afraid it was over a week.
I thought it was more like 3 weeks. Anyway, so James is now hooked up, has a CGM on his arm as we speak. I do too. James, actually, I'm going to do a little strip routine here and take my shirt off and show mine while you tell a little bit about what you're finding out.
Yeah, my experience, there it is. Mine's in the same spot, but I'm going to keep my clothes on. Otherwise, you'd have a Bigfoot sighting, a very small Bigfoot sighting if I took my shirt off. There's three things that I've discovered in the 2 weeks that I've been doing it, and I'm a big fan at this point. I misunderstood, as you said. I was thinking, the Libre was, I knew what the Dexcom was. They, I guess, did a better job of advertising to me. I was anticipating with the Libre, it was more of a finger stick, you know, traditional meter, but it wasn't. It's just the same. It's a continuous glucose monitor that attaches. But there's three things, and I have no economic interest whatsoever in Dexcom and Libre ever sent any of those. We've looked at a number of them. So this is pure review. So I'm embracing it and I like it a lot. I like what it's done for me over the last 2 weeks, but I'd describe it in three ways. Number one, it's easy to do. Two, it's engaging. And three, it's effective. I alliterated those by accident, but that is true. All three things, I find it. Number one, easy. Probably the most common question people have is I've told people the last 2 weeks what I'm doing. And when some people have seen it, when I've had a short sleeve shirt on, they immediately think, they start feeling sorry for me. I didn't realize you had something wrong with you. So, well, it's not a mental health device, if that would be appropriate, but it doesn't hurt. So it was easy to apply it. It comes in an applicator. My pharmacist recommend that I use some skin adhesive strip to make sure it stays on. So I was easily able to apply it, and it was easy to sync with my smartphone, like yourself, Ford. I have an iPhone. And those two things sync very easily. Those of you who are watching who may think that you have technology challenges. Now, I don't know what to do if you have a flip phone or, you know, or something, but if you have a smartphone, easiest thing. There's also another meter you can get from the pharmacy, but I find it works very well with my phone. The only negative that I found with it, I said, is it will train you to make sure you walk around corners very broadly, because I have caught it a couple of times on corners, and that's the only time you're going to feel it is if you catch it on a corner of a door or something like that when you're walking in a room. But it stays on. It's very stable. It's very easy. It's engaging. I am very aware, although I would forget that I have it on even sleeping at night, I'm very aware during the day that my choices are going to impact that. So I test it a lot more than usual very early. And now I've fallen into traditional a couple times a day and track it. I look at all the impacts, the daily patterns. The software allows you to go in and do something that's very important, and that's the log. So I can log what I've eaten. I can log what I've drank. I can log behaviors. Have I exercised? Was I active? And then I've done something, as you've said, I'm overlaying it myself a little bit, where I download it on my iPhone, a sleep app. And each night when I go to bed, I turn that sleep on app on, and it tracks my sleep. I was a little skeptical of these sleep apps. However, I've engaged with it and I've noticed a pattern. In the mornings, on nights that it tells me I did not sleep well, my fasting glucose is always higher. So last night it told me I had a terrible sleep, and I did. I only deep slept for about 1 hour, and I light slept for about 5 hours, even though I went to bed early. I went to bed early. For some reason, I wouldn't go into why I didn't sleep well. I woke up a lot last night. But this morning when I did my fasting glucose, it was at 100. Normally I'm in the high 80s to low 90s. And so I track my sleep and I track my blood sugar, my fasting, as well as my afternoons. And I have a very consistent pattern throughout the day. I am very mindful of what I'm eating, what I'm drinking. But I find the most interesting thing is that my cortisol, evidently, we can talk about that and then talk about leptin as a hormone, cortisol as an hormone, and obesity. But there is something evidently in the mornings, maybe because I'm starting my day, I'm talking with you on the phone very early in the mornings, that's raising my cortisol levels because of stress, maybe, who knows. And my blood sugar is the highest is in the morning when I'm fasting. It's higher than after lunch when I eat. Of course, I'm on a high fat, low carb diet. So my 3 o'clock numbers are significantly lower than my 9 o'clock numbers, especially on nights when I don't get 3-4 hours of REM sleep.
That's not uncommon at all. I get a lot of folks, one of the things they focus on once they start realizing the importance of blood sugar is they focus on what's called the dawn effect. The dawn effect is due to the fact that the vast majority of us have an increase in cortisol between 4 and 6 in the morning. That cortisol causes our liver to start pushing out glucose. I have never seen a dawn effect which was routinely getting people into dangerous levels blood sugar. When we'll have an event, we'll often take these finger sticks with us and people will be surprised. They'll say, wait a minute, my blood sugar was higher before breakfast than it was afterwards. And just like you've described, what happens is your glucose is being pushed by cortisol in the morning. You eat something and then you get a bolus of insulin as a response to what you eat. So we've got quite a few comments. And again, I think folks that use this CGM begin to realize there's a whole bunch of stuff that I learned. And we used to say, eat to the glucometer. James was saying, gosh, you know what? You live to the glucometer. I realize what you need to be doing in terms of developing muscle mass. The more you develop good muscle mass, the better those muscles pull that blood sugar in, even if your receptors are resistant to insulin. Sleep, big impact. We just talked about some of that. You get poor sleep and your blood sugars are going to average a little bit higher for the next 48 hours. And obviously stuff like activity. You can take a carb vacation, which many of us will do during these upcoming holidays. Remember, you take a carb vacation, you go a little bit higher on your blood sugar, you walk around, you don't have to do major aggressive hill runs, just gentle walking will pull that sugar out of your blood and into the muscles, the large muscles of your body. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just gonna have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process. And that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a Freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrest.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.